friends, and welcome back again. So in this video, let's learn what is Joule Thomson effect. When an ideal gas is passed through a throttling valve at constant enthalpy, the temperature of the gas entering in remains same as the temperature of the gas coming out, that is T1 is equal to T2. But this is not same in the case of real gases. In the year 1852, Joule and William Thomson found out that gases undergo change in temperature due to sudden change in pressure. When a real gas is passed through any restriction, such as throttling valve, porous plug, or any ordinary valve, at constant enthalpy, it undergoes change in pressure. This sudden change in pressure leads to temperature change. The temperature may rise, fall, or remain constant. This effect of change in temperature due to sudden change in pressure is called as Joule Thomson effect. Now, here's a little activity for you guys. Blow your air with your mouth wide open and feel the air. You may notice that the air is a little bit warmer. Now, repeat the same process with your lips pursed. This time, you may see that the air is cooler. Interesting, isn't it? So guys, this is a very famous analogy of throttling process. This method of throttling air has proven important in advancements such as refrigeration, heat pumps, air conditioning, and liquefiers. Now let us understand how this pressure change affects the change in temperature. For this, Joule Thomson has plotted a graph between pressure and temperature. Here P1 is the highest pressure. Now in the graph, as you can see, if the gas is compressed from P1 to P2, you may notice rise in temperature. That is, T2 is higher than T1. Also, if it is further compressed from P1 to P3, the temperature rises again. In the case of P2 and P3, when the gas is compressed from P2 to P3, the temperature remains the same. And when it is further compressed from P3 to P4, between the temperature T3 and T4, you can see that the temperature decreases or falls. Now, the maximum temperature in this curve is called as inversion temperature. In this curve, you may notice that if the pressure change occurs on the right-hand side of the inversion temperature, the temperature always rises. And if the pressure changes occurs on the left-hand side of the inversion temperature, the temperature always falls. The tangent at any point on the curve is given by mu is equal to dou p by dou t. This is known as Joule Thomson coefficient. As you can see here, the left hand side of the inversion temperature has a positive slope. Hence, if mu is positive, then the fluid cools. Whereas, on the right hand side of the inversion temperature, the curve has negative slope. Hence, when mu is negative, the fluid warms. This is what is Joule Thomson effect. That's it for today's video, guys. I hope you liked it. Thank you.